So once we've substituted this with alkyl groups, there's more chemistry that's available to us, and a lot of this was covered much earlier on. So one of the things that we can do is we can brominate this in the presence of light using a radical reaction. This is actually a rather stable thing to do. And we end up adding the bromine right here. So CH2CH3, excuse the abbreviation right there. And then if we also want to add, N-bromosacinamide, NBS, in the presence of heat and peroxide, we can end up adding it to a terminal carbon as well. Okay, so we've got a couple different places where we can end up adding bromine. So this works out pretty well. We've brominated these things. And now we can just sort of treat something like this, and if I just sort of circle around it, you can see we can treat this like it's a carbon chain with a bromine on it, and then that we know we can do some bromines with this. So various substitutions and eliminations. So focusing on this one here for a second, this is the one that kind of comes down over this way. If we just simply substitute this out in an SN2 type reaction, we get the hydroxide added there. Same sort of thing with this, and then the bromine comes off, that's its own anion. Same sort of thing here with the cyanide. And our bromine ends up coming off. And then we can also, if we want, we can add an NH3 group to it. So here we have this, now it adds it's more of like a cation, and then we treat it with a little bit of base so that we can get CH2NH2. So we get a primary amine there where we used to have one. Okay, so those are all different sets of reactions, and you can go back several chapters to find out, to remind yourself all of the different substitution and elimination reactions that could possibly go on and the conditions they need. Don't forget that elimination is also something that can happen, and so if we have a base here, we can end up kicking off this bromine and taking a hydrogen from here, and when we do that, we end up getting a CH double bond CH2. Okay, so we can make one of these, I think this is styrene, so we can end up making that as well. So substitution and elimination are not the only things that we can go through and make. We can also do some oxidation and reduction. So starting here with the reduction, if we have hydrogen on a palladium over carbon catalyst, our benzene ring is not very easily reduced, so we can end up making CH2CH3, basically eliminating the double bond there, adding across it. We can do the same thing with rainy nickel. So if we have two equivalents of hydrogen over rainy nickel, then this becomes a CH2 and this will become an NH2. So we've kind of fully reduced it. Every place where there was multiple bonds now has hydrogens on it. All right, so again, rainy nickel is one of those things we need. Don't forget it's pyrophoric, don't leave it out. Okay, if we have this methylated and we want to oxidize it here, so those first two are reductions, we want to oxidize it. We do that with chromic acid, CrO4, in the presence of heat, and what that'll do is that'll turn this into an acid group, so that becomes C double bond OOH. Okay, and no matter how long the chain is, the same thing will happen, so we'll make a C double bond OOH. Provided that there's at least one hydrogen on the carbon that can do that. If there are no hydrogens here, so if this was a trimethyl group, no reaction would occur, but we still make this product. Okay, so if this was the species that was going to react, we had three methyl groups on there, there would be no reaction with that because there's no hydrogen on here that we can use. So if we were to look at question 7D, if we were to brominate this in the presence of light, that would go there, and then we substitute this off. This would go in the presence, CH2CN. This would go in the presence of that, and then we hydrogenate it. and we can arrive at that. You are going to want to be familiar with all of the different reactions that can take place, so go back and revisit these. Also, at the end of the chapter, and Bruce, and again, we're in chapter 18, there will be a lot of different reactions summarized there. So look for the reaction summary at the end of Bruce. Okay? So good luck with everything that you're doing. Hope all is well.